Welcome to the performance of A Farm for Mimi. I am Priscilla Hell, the executive director of allgo, a queer people of color organization based in Austin, Texas. Our work consists of social justice, cultural arts, and health and wellness programming. allgo is thrilled to be working again with Virginia Grise on this moving work about the importance of South Central farming, community, and the ways in which art is so necessary and powerful. We congratulate Vicky on the creation of this outstanding work, as well as all the folks who have made it possible. Thank you to Innovations in Socially Distanced Performance at Princeton's Lewis Center for the Arts, the City of Austin Economic Development and Cultural Arts Division, the Alice Kleberg Foundation, Cara Mía Theatre, and A Todo Dar Productions. Thank you for joining us and enjoy the show.
Buenas tardes. Soy David Lozano, director artístico y ejecutivo de Teatro Cara Mía, un teatro Latinx en Dallas, Texas. Es un honor para mí presentar A Farm for Meme, escrito por Virginia Grise y dirigida por Elena Araoz. También es un honor colaborar con Algo, organización queer POC que cubre todo Texas. Quiero agradecer a nuestros patrocinadores, la Fundación de Andrew W. Mellon y HowlRound Theatre Commons, por apoyar la nueva residencia que la escritora Virginia Grise tendrá con Cara Mía por los próximos 3 años. Estamos muy emocionados de presentar este primer proyecto de Virginia con Cara Mía, A Farm for Meme. Y quiero agradecer también a Todo Dar Productions, Innovations in Socially Distanced Performance at Princeton's Lewis Center for the Arts por su colaboración y apoyo. Y reconocer a la comunidad del South Central Farm en Los Ángeles, quienes en 1992 se unieron para crear un campo de siembra urbano. Precisamente después de una rebelión contra la policía como la que Ceci vive en estos momentos. A Farm for Meme habla sobre la posibilidad de imaginar un nuevo mundo en el momento contemporáneo. Felicidades, Virginia. Tu visión se hace tangible con este primer proyecto. Gracias por colaborar con nosotros y a todos ustedes. Bienvenidos a un Farm for Meme. Enjoy the show. Disfruten la obra.
Is that a tree?
Mm-hmm. Remember, that's the walnut tree from the story?
Oh, yeah.
What color do you want to do that?
Do we have to draw walnuts?
You could. Yeah.
You want?
Yeah. What's walnuts look like?
They're kind of like brown, like nuts.
Are they like brown?
Mm-hmm.
Are they like
blue? But then circles? You can do the leaves like a different
like
color.
Like a walnut. Mm-hmm. Like these.
Mm-hmm. Then you could always do the leaves like the other part of the tree, like green or...
I live in Los Angeles. They say the highest point in the city is in City Terrace, somewhere near Coyoacanqui Square. I look for that place when I'm lost. I live near El Tepeyac, where they make burritos the size of your head
like the aguacates viejitas grow on trees in their front yards.
I live in a big blue house behind a bamboo fence, falling, backseat of a truck pulled out, turned lawn chair, roosters roaming, a cactus garden with a beautiful woman named Vanessa. We call her V. DJ. She spins records and poetry, raising three boys, 4, 3, and 1, on prayers and a whole lot of love. In between gigs, she stays home and teaches them how to read. The oldest, we call him Lil Man, and the youngest, we call him Baby. Baby se come todo. He eats everything. If you're not careful, he will steal the food off of your plate. And the other two boys don't like to eat at the same table as him. They blame him for everything. But it doesn't seem to bother Baby one bit. V and the boys used to live on the South Central Farm, in an encampment, trying to save it from the police and the bulldozers. Emmanuel, we call him Meme. He once told me that one day he was going to build a farm and that everyone could come live on his land with their tents. Meme told me he doesn't like bulldozers. And even though he's only 3, he explained to me in an old man's voice that when you pull something out of the ground, it grows back. Don't worry, we're going to plant more things, he said. Hailstorm, the Foxy, are the extended family that Vanessa has created of rappers, musicians, poets,
and DJs. They take turns taking care of the boys and each other. There is always a party outside my window. Cumbias, rancheras, banda, Johnny Cash. I wake to the sounds of roosters in the morning. It all sounds a little crazy, but whenever it gets to be too much, I just go up the stairs and retreat to my bedroom. White clouds painted on the ceiling, blue. Like right now, Hailstorm is in the laundry room finishing her tattoo. Her father's homeboy, Lupe, has a homemade tattoo gun. Made the motor of the machine with a Walkman, held together with rubber bands to keep the needle from jumping. I'm amazed at the details of the three feathers on her neck. He yells at her, "Stay still, girl. I told you not to move. I hit a vein." Hailstorm is getting her feathers before she moves to Seattle, where she will play hip hop for indigenous elders. Drums play on the radio. Sage burns in a shell. Black ink on neck. White candle burning. The feather of a bird. Yamayas maracas. Kitchen, same color as my grandmother's, green, is where we all gather. Two men sell tacos al pastor, $2 for $2 on the corner of Evergreen. They make them straight out of a sartén and a barril on the streets. You can get a carton of oat milk at the friendly market on Blades, where the cholos like to hang out on the corner waiting for the girls to pass by. So we send Foxy to get our food. Nobody messes with Foxy. On special occasions, we like to treat ourselves to Thai food on Cesar Chavez or Rocky Road ice cream from El Superior. On Monday nights, the Black Nationalist bookstore on the corner gives free classes on how to learn Chinese. It's where grown men talk about grown things.
Take me outside, sit in the green garden. Nobody out there, but it's okay now. Bathe in the sunlight, don't mind if rain falls. Take me outside, sit in the green garden. Fly. Wings of a butterfly, high as a treetop, down again.
On Monday nights, the Black Nationalist Bookstore on the corner gives free classes on how to learn Chinese. It's where grown men talk about grown things, how things used to be and how things ain't the same no more. I walk past them, snatching up bits and pieces of their grown men talk. Ideas everywhere spill out my pockets. Let the stories fall to the ground. Use them to fertilize the soil. Plant tomato plants in the potholes. Grow trees on sidewalks. Let their roots break open concrete. Chickens in our backyard like to lay their eggs behind the lemon tree. V always wakes up early before anybody else. She likes to sit outside, feel the sun on her skin, give thanks for the day, picks flowers from the garden. She remembers the farm. Sky blue, day clear, a walnut tree. A woman in the walnut tree turned butterfly. A single butterfly flying towards the sun. Flowers everywhere float in a light that turns from blue to yellow to green. The butterfly has finally found a home on the treetops inside a walnut tree. Don't let them bulldoze the trees. Day fades into darkness, interrupted by bursts of light. The night, stars, the cars, streets, the moon. Close my eyes and dream.
Thank you for the sun. Thank you for the rain, for today. Take care of our mountains, our rivers, the butterfly in the walnut tree. Take care of her. The butterfly is a messenger. The butterfly is a warrior. The butterfly flies over continents in search of home. She has not eaten in 17 days. She is hungry, but she is strong. She is hungry, but she is home. Home is a farm in South Central Los Angeles. Meme, promise me you'll always remember the farm.
Mash the kernels in a metate. 5,000-year-old Oaxacan loop corn. Walk a circle of protection around the house. Throw away barrels and barrels of broken glass so that we can grow green amaranth, hierbabuena, chayote. Eat the fruit, turn the root to tea. Alache y chipilin, purple flowers, rich legumes. We didn't learn this in school. How to turn the guayaba leaf into medicine? What day to plant the yerba mora? How to mix the malabar gourd with honey, make palenquetas? Know where the sun sets and rises, where the mountains are, in what direction is the ocean? Tempasuchi, orange and yellow marigolds, welcome our ancestors. Nuestros antepasados once showed us how to work the land with our hands so that we could have something to call our own. 14 acres of farmland in the middle of South Central Los Angeles after the riots. The first thing that grew was the cactus. Uno de los siete guerrilleros, nopal is strong and independent. And then the other plants grew too. In January, avocados, banana, and cabbage grew. In February, mushrooms, squash, and mangoes grew. In March, artichokes and grapefruits grew. In April, radishes, pineapple, and spinach grew. We planted. Those that had always lived there, and those that had just arrived. We prayed for the farm, and it grew. On the corner of 41st and Alameda, we created something, something we could call our own. We learned how to work with the land and with each other. Then came their bulldozers. Sun, hot, hits the asphalt, black. The bulldozers tore down the fence to the farm, uprooted the plants, rows and rows of cabbage, carrots, beets, a guayaba tree, avocados, tamarindo, vines bearing huge pumpkins, chayote, a loquat tree, maíz, until the farm was just an empty lot. Except for the walnut tree. It's illegal to kill walnut trees in Los Angeles. Meme, Mimi knows the words for police, for bulldozers, the word for helicopters. But Mimi remembers the farm. He knows what kempasuchit is, knows the word for sweet potato and pumpkin in Spanish, camote y calabaza. Mimi knows the difference between rosemary and mint. In Mimi's eyes, I see the butterfly. I see the walnut tree. In Mimi's eyes, I see light. In Mimi's eyes, I see love. When you pull something out of the ground, it grows back. Don't worry. We're going to plant more things. Mm-hmm. Meme is learning capoeira at the community gardens in East LA. He's trying to decide if he wants to be a ninja or a warrior, switching his bandana from face to head. I tell him he could be both. He insists that's impossible. And he takes his bandana off and decides that he is going to sew together all of his bandanas and make a kite stretched across bamboo sticks. Meme knows how to make kites that fly in the sky. One day, he too will soar above the treetops. One day, he'll become a butterfly. Even after the bulldozers came and tore the garden down, el nopal sigue creciendo. La caña, the sugar cane, and the bananas still grow.